follow the leader.
Yo, Krabby here, answering some questions on primitive race. I'll do as best I can. Well, for me, there were no real preconceived ideas. It just seemed a cool project to do. I was getting sent through some loops and audio files, and they all sounded well and groovy to me and instantly gave me ideas, and I wanted to join the crew and get in there and get things moving. So I don't know what the new generation think of it. I'm not sure that I'm that bothered, really. It's sometimes creating music is a bit of a selfish act, in that I think you get the best out of yourself, really, just by following your heart and just trying to make it the best that you can and not really worrying about too much else.
A toothless smile, you call up the feds when your head should be laid in bed.
Well, it's quite similar to the Pop Release Itself album that we just done, in that it was done remotely, sending files back and forth, although it's kind of different in that there were more members and more input, and that was quite cool, really, because you never knew where the next file or loop was coming from, and it was great, just that collective, everyone pulling together and trying to make a good album out of it. So kind of not that different, but just really the number of members in the project made it different. That song was initially named after a guy who had enormous testicles, but it was changed because I think when originally written, we didn't realise how serious a condition it was, and the guy eventually died from that condition. So it was time for a sober reflection, really, and realise that it wasn't the right thing to do. And so the song changed direction, really, is now Platinum Balls, but the idea now really is that if you're lacking balls, go out and purchase some. Humour and wit, I don't know, I think sometimes you throw things at the wall, see what sticks. Sometimes they're stupid ideas, sometimes they work, and that's just the way it's approached, really. Again, no preconceived idea on it, just try and be natural.
There could be no reason not to open your ears and to purchase New Year Platinum Balls.
I don't think there's been many hip-hop collaborations, probably because it's street music and it's very self-contained, really, so I think collaborations would probably only serve to dilute that. It's pretty strong on its own 2 feet, really, and doesn't want to be watered down, is my guess, although there are notable exceptions, obviously. The early guitar crossover with Beasties, Run DMC and all of that, current hip hop artists, there's some good British grime, some good rappers there, JME, Skepta, Bizzle, Wiley. But who would I collaborate with? Probably Chuck D would be number one on the list. Obviously, we have a bit of a connection going back a few years, and he's still rocking it. PE still doing the business, so yeah. Not really. I think they're best kept separate. No reason why it couldn't be, other than really when I think people come to watch you, they're expecting a certain thing, and I think blurring the lines too much kind of loses the focus of what you're trying to perform and, you know, what you're trying to portray. So I think it's a good idea to keep things separate. Any chance of us touring? Possibly. We'll have to see, really. There's a lot of people, and whether it can afford to sort of pay the wages of whoever it needs to pay is a different matter entirely. So that's kind of what will be the deciding factor, but I think we are due to investigate that, so we'll see, hopefully. I am the best. I took my shit. I'm not necessarily a fan of that. I think, you know, you release the version, the finished version, because you like it and you think it's right. There have been occasions when demos have been released, but they tend to happen way after the event. And, well, who knows? It's not something I'm going to spend a lot of time thinking about, to be honest. That was written just after my mother died, which was quite an emotive time. Well, not quite an emotive time. It was quite devastating to anyone who's experienced that type of thing. And it was just about feeling angry with the world and being confused and just struggling to come to grips with it, really. But it's been quite a long time now, so the pain gradually subsides. But yeah, that was RSVP. It's pretty good, really, because you've got time to correct every mistake and perfect everything that you want perfected. But to be honest, most albums are not jammed. Most albums are recorded, the parts are recorded separately, so that you can focus on what's been done, correct what needs to be corrected. So yeah, I mean, maybe very straight rock bands might perform an album live in the studio, but not very often. Inside your skin, start at the end, it's a means to begin. You've got no way of knowing, you're no one with nowhere to go. You just follow the leader. I wouldn't mind, it's a lot of work. Yeah, it could be a serious amount of time on stage, but yeah, possibly, maybe. No way of knowing, you're no one with nowhere to go. You just follow the leader. What might we expect? More songs? I don't know, we've only just finished this one. Patience. yeah, just still digesting this one, really. I mean, I haven't really heard all the feedback and reviews and what people think of it, so that's the next stage, really. And I think it's good to clear your head a bit and before you start thinking of a next record. That's certainly how I work anyway. I tend to sort of work pretty manically on something and then just like to completely get it out of my head for 6 months or whatever before I even start thinking of doing a next record. No one with nowhere to go. You just follow the lead. Okay, well, I hope that answers a few of your questions, and thank you for being so interested. And yeah, I hope you dig the record. and maybe Primitive Race get out live, hopefully. Okay, cheers, see ya, bye.
Nowhere to go. You just follow the lead, and no way of knowing, you're no one with nowhere to go. Follow the fucking lead.